What's up YouTube, Doswell Beats back with another video. If this is your first time to the channel, as always, welcome. Please don't forget to like, share, subscribe, hit that notification button to get notified whenever I drop some heat. Alright, I dropped a video yesterday. One of my subscribers in the comment, because normally when I drop my videos, I always leave a comment, say, let me know what you want to see next, or, you know, help me get this video to a certain amount of likes. So under the one where I said, let me know what you want to see next, somebody said, breaking down sample chops. All right. So in this video, that's what I'm going to show you how to do. I'm going to show you how to break down sample chops. All right. So it's more than one way to do sample chops. I'm gonna show you two ways that I like to do it. All right, let's go, let's get it. All right, now we inside the MPC software. Here go the sample right here we're gonna use today. All right, let's just drag it in. What I like to do first, I either chop it inside the sample edit. I either go to sample edit and chop it up, find the loop and then chop it up, or I could go in, I just bring it right into the audio section and drop it into the audio section right here. All right, the first way I'm gonna show you is doing it inside the sample chop, the sample edit. All right, so we inside sample edit now. So if you know your BPM and you know what key is in, that makes it much easier for you. But if you don't know what the BPM is, I'm gonna show you how to find the BPM. So you'll come into your sample, you'll come into your sample edit, drag it in there, and then hit the first pad one. That plays the loop for you, and all you got to do is just listen where you hear it loop at. All right, so let's go. Right there. All right, so right here it loops right here. All right, it loop right here. So what we need to do is figure out if it loop perfectly, right? To find out if it loop perfectly, you'll hit pad 16. All right, pad 16, do a loop, keep looping the song, keep looping the beat. So we hit pad 16. Loop perfectly, you hear it? All right, so what you can do from here is just hit discard right here. Hit discard. What discard does is chop everything off from here, and if anything is on this side, it'll chop it off. All right, so everything that's in the middle of this green and red will be kept. So let's just hit do it. There you go. So now that's a perfect loop right there, right? That loop is perfect. So now what we want to do is make sure the MPC tells you what the key is, right? And it's showing the key, the right key, what the sample is in. If you're on the hardware, you just hit the tech key right here. If you're in the software, just hit the tech key and it tells you what it is, C sharp minor, right? So before I do anything else, I like to listen to it and then try to feel what key I want it in. I don't want to keep it at the same place where I got the sample. I want to change it. So what we could do is right here where it say tune, I don't normally like to do that because that slows it and it makes it, it don't change it right here when you change it from here. Say you want to drop it like, let's drop it, let's drop it -4. Let me show you. All right, now let's listen to it. All All right, so what that did was that slowed it down, and it pitched it down, but it also slowed it down. We wanted to stay at the same speed, but still pitch it down. All right, for that, let's go back to zero right here. And then what you need to do is go into pitch right here. All right. And then you do the negative four right there. Do negative four. Then do it. Once you do it, then you hit the tech key. And the key tell you now is in A minor. Now, it keep it the same. We're going to listen to it. It keep it the same tempo, but it pushed it down to A minor. All right. So let's go. Let's listen to it. The same tempo, it didn't slow it down or nothing, it just pitched it down. This tune right here, it pitch it and it slow it down. So if you want that effect, you can do that, but it doesn't. When you go to detect, if you use this and you go to detect, it doesn't, it keep it in this original, the original, it show you that the original key that it was in. It don't switch it to A minor like how you seen me switch it. But when you use the pitch shift, it changes the key. Up here doesn't change the key and it slows it down. All right, so from there, let's move on. After that, what I normally do, since we already pitched it down, we changed the tempo and everything, I like to go to let me see if I find it in here. Instead of right here, instead of trim, we'll go to chop. Instead of manual, we could go to BPM or we could go to threshold. Since it's a perfect loop, let's just do BPM because it's perfect loop. All right, so let's go to BPM. And it just give you each thing. All right, so that right there is how I do my sample chops. Then what you can do is hit the shift button and do convert, or you can come right here and hit new program. Right, once you hit new program, just hit do it. You can do the non-destructive. I already have a video explaining the non-destructive and the pad parameters. All right, so if you want to see that video, you can go check it out in my channel list. Just say non-destructive or whatever. All right, so we're gonna do non-destructive for the video, and let's just hit do it. Now we go back home. Now I'm in the drum program. Here go all our chops. All right, so let's listen. All right, so you can either put it down now. So it tells you what the BPM was. So let's go to the 146. Before we do anything and try to put everything on the lay everything down, we need to go into the warp our sample, right? So up here, you can come to wave, then you can hit warp. But before you hit warp, warp is right here, but we want to affect every single chop at one time. So edit zone, where edit zone at? Right here. Okay, so you come to edit zone, and instead of it being on current, you'll go on all. Once you go on all, then you want to hit warp. Now it's warping every single one of these chops. Instead of going to individual section and then hitting warp and individual warp. Now once you do that, make sure to set the BPM right here. That's the section that I missed. Set the BPM right here to whatever the sample was. The sample was 146, so we can set it to 146. All right, now let's go back. Go to the grid editor. You can tell by your chops, right? Since it's in BPM, it should go from the first chop should last from here to here. That's the first chop. Let's see. You see that? First chop should last from here to here. Okay, it happened. All right, now let's go ahead and just lay something down. So that's how you do that there, right? So now that's how I do my sample chops, but it's more in details. And once you start getting used to that part, then you'll figure out more and more advanced stuff. But that's just a simple way how to do breaking down sample chops. All right. So another way that I like to do it, let's delete all these because we don't need them no more. That part of the video is done. Let's go to right here to audio. All right, so now the sample, I'm on 8 bars. Now the sample is in, right? So let's go ahead and play. All right, so this is the second way that I like to do it. We'll just drag the audio inside the audio track, and then we'll chop it from there. All right, let's go. All right. All right, that's a perfect loop right there. So what we could do, we don't need the rest of that. We'll just close it off for now, right? And then let's just open it back up. I like to change the key of the sample. So on this particular one, I would just change it from right here. Go down, let's go down 4. All right, -4. Now let's play it. Then what I like to do is just chop them at each bar, or do your own thing, chop them at each half bar, right? I do it either way, either half bar or a full bar. And then what I like to do is sometimes I do it where you hear the chord progression, like the I like to chop them there too, right? But you, once you get the hang of it, you just go through and do your own thing. Like right here, right here is one of them where I normally chop at, right? So another thing that I like to do is go back on my select tool, select this, and just reverse it, right? If you ever watch the FL Studio video where they reverse their sample and then chop it up and then move the back end to the front and then move the second to the like keep moving them around, it's the same principle right here. But only thing I did first was chop them. So then all I have to do is just reverse each one. I don't have to move it back and forth. So right there, hit the reverse. Right here, hit 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 reverse. Hit reverse, and hit reverse. Right now let's play it. Just listen. Thank you. All right. And then what I like to do too, to mix it up, I'll come right here to the track view, create another audio track, and just mix, move them around. Move this here, move this back here, and then play. Like, we can move anyone anywhere. I'm not doing it to just to make it sound good. I'm just doing it to show y'all like the steps you could take to do it. All right, so let's go back to, you know me, I like to add something to it. You can, once you're in your 808, you can come right here to your tools and do your tuner. We know it's right. We hitting C. Let's hit the C and C. C. All right. A. All right. So it need to be tweaked a little bit, right, with the synths, because you see it's a little bit off, but it's that's good enough. All right. Just for the video is good enough. So let's go. Alright, so in a nutshell, that's how I do my sampling, my sample chops. It's two ways that I normally do it. It's a third way, but that way is too much to go through in this video, right? But those two ways right there is a great way for you to start, and is not that complicated, right? So let's go, man. Let's get it. I'm helping my subscribers out, man. 2024, we helping out the subscribers, alright? If you don't know, ask me. I try to get it in for you, all right? If I know, I'll get it in. If I don't know, I'll tell you I don't know, all right? So let's go. Let's get it, man. Catch you in the next one. Tony up!